Tesla's pioneered a lot of breakthroughs in the world of AI. It was actually Tesla's engineer, Andrej Karpathy, who pioneered the term software 2.0, which is this idea of, can software or can AI make software better than humans can? The big innovation with software 2.0 is realizing that you don't actually have to write code in order to make machines smarter. You just have to feed it better data. Better data means that the data is better labeled. So one of the futures of software development, according to Andrej Karpathy, is more similar to data entry and to annotating and labeling data, and less about actually writing code. There will still be regular software developers, but a lot of times those software developers are going to be building better user interfaces and better tools for the software 2.0 developers in order to be doing their job. What are the software 2.0 developers going to be doing? They're going to be labeling data in order to make machines smarter.
Really, the way to look at it, I think a good kind of framework to have in mind is that if you'd like to design the code yourself, this is software 1.0, you sit down and you write some Python or C++, then you're going to identify some piece of the program space, you write an algorithm, and the algorithm can't be too complex, so it's somewhere around the origin, because we're finite people. So that's one solution, and then you can evaluate it, and then you can iterate on your algorithm. When you're approaching this from kind of the software 2.0 perspective, you're instead specifying a subset of programs that you're going to search over. So a convolutional neural network architecture, you're basically identifying a piece of the program space that you are willing to search for the solution in, and then the optimization actually finds a part of that program space that works really well on your data or on your problem. So the optimization really writes the code. We only identify a region where we should search.
So for instance, if you were a software 2.0 developer, you would be labeling data in, let's say, the Tesla auto driving system. Let's say that there is a new type of stop sign inside of Norway, and the machines are having to re-understand and relearn how to interpret the stop signs. So the software 2.0 developer would be adjusting and labeling the data that the AI will be consuming, as opposed to the old method, which was software 1.0, which was more about hard coding the static rules and giving it static top-down logic of how to interpret the data that was being fed. Thanks for watching. And if you want to know how you can amplify your business with AI, you can click on the link below, and that will take you to 5 case studies showing how we've implemented AI across our businesses.